It's the NFL on EA Sports, where we'll see two of the NFL's oldest and most storied franchises. It's the New York Giants and the Pittsburgh Steelers on Monday night.
Well, to the locals, it's still and will always be Heinz Field. But for the rest of us, we're along the North Shore of the Allegheny and Ohio Rivers at Acrisure Stadium in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Thanks for joining us, everyone. With my partner, Brock Heward, I'm Kate Scott. And like so many matchups in the NFL, Brock, our focus goes right to the quarterbacks in this one. Both of these guys, players who've been around the league now for some time, they definitely established themselves as veterans who know how to win football games.
Yeah, I think the word of the day, Kate, is definitely experience. Two guys who've been through the season several times over, have seen a lot at this point in their career and been through quite a bit on the field. All that experience is stored up there right between the ears. And the one who is more skilled at leveraging that experience, more than likely is going to come away with the win.
Ball is teed up. Chris Boswell to do the honors. And we're off from Acrisure. Fielded at the 7. His return makes it up to the 25. So out come the Giants. Their first drive of the game coming up. Leading them out in his 6th NFL season since being picked 6th overall, Daniel Jones.
Jones has had a tumultuous career. That's with a capital T, by the way, that continues to have some ups and downs. Maybe part of that's playing under the bright lights in the big city of New York. But he's had some tough outings. He's had some brilliant outings. He's had some ups. He's had some downs. But he did take a team to the playoffs, and he's got to use that experience, build off of that confidence, to do it again.
Start the drive with Singletary. He's corralled after a modest 4-yard gain. Tackling like his dad, Joey Porter Jr. making that play.
You know, Kate, these are some of the little hidden plays in the game. It doesn't look like a whole lot on the stat sheet, but A, it gets a good yardage. B, it sets up your play action. And C, most importantly, keeps that defense guessing.
They go play fake with Jones. We do have a flag down, but it might not be good news for their offense. That's usually where we see holding calls. He got a major fistful of jersey on that play, and it's going to end up costing him. All right, here we go. Second down. On the shotgun, it's Jones. He's holding up. They're able to drop it. And that pushes him back.
Might just be a little late to get the ground game going, opening up this game with back-to-back passes. But when you come out of the gate slow and you put yourself behind the sticks, you really don't get in that rhythm you want to find early.
Defense with an excellent opportunity and a stop here on third down. Looking from the gun, here's Jones. He finds Johnson. And a nice game here, but it stops short of the first.
Feet and eyes, Kate. Feet and eyes, they so often tell the story of every position on the field. When that quarterback's feet and eyes move to his secondary read, and so often it's a tight end, it's incumbent on that defense to fly to the ball. You want to make that tackle, force the fourth down? It took a great defensive effort to do it.
They bring on the punt team, and they get this kick away. Calls fair catch and has it inside the 40-yard line. So here are the Steelers now, taking over for the first time. Leading them out, the man in his 13th NFL season and rising quickly up the career leaderboards, Russell Wilson.
Kate, Russell Wilson's one of the NFL's most experienced quarterbacks. He's also one of the winningest quarterbacks, even with a couple bumps in the road in Denver. Remember, over that decade in Seattle with Pete Carroll and the Legion of Boom, there wasn't a quarterback that won more games in the history of the league over the first 10 years. 9 times to the Pro Bowl as well. Put a supporting cast around him, give him a run game and a defense, and Russell Wilson still knows very well how to play this game.
He's going to go down right along midfield strike. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And that's a Steelers first down.
this offense will take that from their ground game every time. But I know, because I've been around this league a long time, runs like that, they're really hard to come by. It takes everybody, and maybe a little breakdown there on defense, too, to take advantage of.
And that's good yardage there with a new set of downs to boot.
That's pretty good right there now. You don't always expect a sizable gain when you run it on first down. You just want some yards to set up an easier second down play. But they will take that execution every time.
First down now, ball at the 39-yard line. Now an inside handoff to Harris. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
This is one of those situations, Kate, where I watch the body language of the running back, because it'd be very easy for him to raise his hands up, look to the sideline in his O-line and go, what am I supposed to do there? There was nothing, no time at all to try and escape and react. Instead, it goes backwards.
Second and 12 behind the sticks. Finds his man, it's Van Jefferson. He runs this to the 25 before being brought down. That one goes for 17 yards and moves the chains.
If they get a handful of these types of plays per game, the pass game coordinator is going to be one happy camper.
All set up now for first and 10. Throwing is Wilson. Jefferson, he's got it. And he's brought down inside the 10 at the 9. That one goes for 15, and now they're going to have first and goal.
Good offenses. Okay, good play callers know how to utilize their personnel. They know where they wanted them. They wanted them on a route in space where he could make that initial play comfortably, but then go to work after.
Trying to run in, Harris. And he's able to fight this down to the 2. It's a gain of 7, and that brings up second and goal.
Hey, I get it on first and goal, right? A lot of teams like to be conservative and limit risk. Even if a run is stopped short, you still got 2, sometimes 3 downs to play with.
Ball at the 2 here for second and goal. Wilson now from the gun. And this is incomplete. Could have been a touchdown, but all it is now is a third down.
That is such a bummer. A dropped touchdown right in the end zone. We're going to see how quickly he can flush this one. He better, because they got to make an impact later.
Third and goal, Wilson. Chased out to his right. Russell Wilson with the touchdown. Great play by the QB there, Brock. The play broke down. He didn't have much of a choice other than to escape and improvise. And in the end, turned out to be the best call he could have made.
It is such a necessary tool in today's NFL for that QB to put right in his tool belt, Kate. You know, in my day, you could be a blacksmith, right? You could just do the job and stay in the pocket. Not anymore. You got to be an artist. And you got to be an artist that can create when things break down. And that's big time to get a touchdown out of it as well.
Going after up and good from Boswell. And the Steelers will jump out to a 7-0 lead. Boswell on to send this away. He fields it from the 8. And he's going to make this to the 28 before going down. Now for the second time this game, we get a look at the New York offense. They didn't start the game off like they wanted, Brock. Still searching for that opening first down as they take the field a second time. Ready to begin this drive, first and 10. Jones now to throw. Man there, it's Malik Nabers. And he'll be brought down a step or two shy of midfield. They're going to mark him at the 48. They get 20 yards out of the play and move the chains.
I know the combine tries to test everything it possibly can physically, but I don't know how you test courage at the combine, because there's nobody defending you. Nobody wants to hit you. But that was the epitome of courage, to make that in cut and make the catch.
That's complete to Darius Slayton. And he's brought down right in the neighborhood of that 40-yard line. They get 13 on the pickup, and the Giants will have a first down.
As a quarterback, when you throw that curl route, you know it's a tight window, Kate. But the minute that DB turns and can't react to the throw, you put it right on your receiver's numbers. He comes back and gets it and moves the sticks.
Gets this to Johnson. And he's out of bounds, just short of the 30.
I know I could sound like a broken record when I talk about timing and getting the ball out on time and on rhythm. But these outcuts, it is so imperative, and the best of them make it look oh so easy.
Second and three now. Again, Jones to the air. Quick slant, caught by Nabers. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with first and goal.
From a great throw, to a nice route and catch, to moving the chains, there wasn't a whole lot not to like about that amazing play.
This offense in position now, it's first and goal. Trying an option play, headed left. And he will take it in, touchdown New York. The Giants reach pay dirt for the first time this game. Daniel Jones with a touchdown. My partner up here is pumping his fist after that one. That is how you run an option as a quarterback. Good read to hang on to it and do it himself.
Yeah, because I could never do that, not even close. But when the defense overplays and you run that option, you get that good two-on-one, more times than not, they will commit to the more dangerous guy, the running back. But you leave a lane, this quarterback can do some damage as well.
Here's Greg Joseph for the extra point. Extra point sent right down the middle. And the Giants tie this game 7-7. Giants ready to kick this one away, and off we go once more. For Darrell Patterson, now to return. Good looking return here, and he's got room. And he gets across the 30 before he's brought down. Here comes the Pittsburgh offense for their second drive of the game. They'll try to emphasize what worked on their last drive, which ended, Brock, in a touchdown. They've got first down from the 31. Now Wilson on the play fake. That one's incomplete over the middle. George Pickens, the intended target. And we'll see what they do here on second down.
That is normally a gimme for this offense, these short throws. But the defense, well, they had just enough influence on that play to force the incompletion.
Second down, Warren. And he got it real close, but stopped just about a yard or so shy of that first down.
Well, that doesn't net a first down. You get yards like that in the run game, you will take it in the NFL.
Third down, 1 yard to go. I'm trying to run it with Harris. They stop him just short and force a fourth and one.
As that linebacker makes that tackle right in the middle of the field, all I'm thinking about right now, Kate, is training camp. Because that's the middle drill right there. That is textbook. What you do in training camp, coming to life when it matters.
So punt coming up on fourth down, and it's against Belgium native Corliss Waitman with the honors. And he's got this fair catch right along the 12-yard line. That punt goes unanswered, no return there. And it'll be Giants football. New York taking over once again, the offense heading out. And that last drive, no answer for what they were doing through the air, so expect some tighter coverage this time around. Drive starts out with a first and 10. Now an inside give to Singletary. And he sneaks this through the middle, maybe a gain of 2. We'll get a stoppage now. Looks like we have someone banged up after that run in need of some attention. Johnson. Following that completion, remember the O-line looks to be in some pain. They're headed out to take a look at him now. Here's Jamie Gillen on again for the punt. Calvin Austin on the return for the Steelers. And little to nothing on that return as the coverage team gets to him. Call that a booming 56 yards in the end. And the Steelers will take over possession. Slated downs to approach here from the 40. First down, here's Russ. Austin's there to haul it in. They'll move the chains after that pickup of 12.
Move the chains! Gotta move them chains! Build momentum and keep that defense on its heels.
First and 10, ball set up at the 48. Running behind center with Harris. And they stop him after a good run that takes him down inside the 40. Give him 9 yards. He almost moved the chains there. It's going to be second and one.
So much to like about that run, Kate, particularly what he was able to get out of it. The defense, I think, feels a little fortunate they were able to track him down before an even bigger run and crossing that first down marker.
Ross off the play fake.
Such a privilege for me to watch Marvin Harrison and Reggie Wayne in person in Indianapolis do their work. Daryl Jackson out in Seattle. They showed how great a deep out is as a chain moving play. It's all about getting that leverage at the top of the route and then exploiting the leverage as that ball arrives on time downfield.
From the gun, they go with Harris. And this almost ended worse, but he gets a yard out of it. Drew Phillips making the tackle. Only gets a yard there to make it second and nine.
Okay, this is why you got to be careful to just run it always on first down. You got to break your tendencies. The casual fan, well, that casual fan knew what was coming, but more importantly, this defensive front did too.
Here we go, second and nine. Targeting the sideline, and Freiermuth has it. And able to get this down to the 15 before going out.
Well, that one came with a high degree of difficulty. Had to balance focusing on the catch, keeping those feet in bounds.
1 yard, all that's needed. This is third and inches. On play action now, Wilson. Pass taken in by Freiermuth. It looks like he went out of bounds right at that 7 yard line. A nice gain of 8 there, and it brings them to first and goal.
You know, Kate, they say a dog is a man's best friend. A tight end that moves the chains on third down, that's a QB's best friend.
They'll break the huddle and come up on first and goal. Russ now from the gun. That's incomplete for the moment. We do have a flag down, but it might not be good news for their offense. That's usually where we see holding calls. So the refs get him for holding, and that's going to back this offense up. Long time to get caught for holding. Backed him up as they'll retry this first and goal. Play action. It's Wilson. Into the end zone, but someone's able to knock it away. That's incomplete.
I don't fault the look downfield at all. I mean, that's just a situation there where it's a better defensive play than the offense executing.
So after the incomplete pass, here's second and goal. They give to Harris from the gun. And he's able to rip off a chunk of red zone yardage to the 10. It's a 70-yard pickup, but still a ways away for third and goal.
I'm not kidding you, Kate. A run of that length at the NFL level, honestly, is the equivalent of a run of 15-plus at the high school level. It's hard in the run game to make yards, and they just got a very successful one.
Third and long for him here. This one's caught. And he drives this forward to the 6.
Those little short throws, they are high percentage and certainly bread and butter. But they really run the risk of a quick tackle just like that and being stopped short of the sticks.
Facing fourth down, the Steelers opting for the field goal. Chris Boswell out to do the honors. High percentage look for him here from the left hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. Going to break our tie and give them a 3-point advantage.
Well, I know once that drive stalls out, that's where it really pays to have that reliable kicker on the sideline ready to bail you out. And he knocks that one right through to give him the lead.
Now Boswell on to send this away. Here's a return from the 7. And pretty solid field position starting out here, Brock. He's tackled at the 29. And the drive will start out with a 1st and 10. Operating from the gun, it's Jones. It was there, but it couldn't hang on. That's incomplete.
You know, the goal on a lot of these short throws is to simply let the receiver create some yards after the catch, that yak. I think he was thinking about the yak before he actually secured the catch.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's 2nd down. From the gun, a carry by Singletary. And he's brought down for a loss. That's the end of our first quarter. Three more to go still on Monday night. Just a field goal separates these two. More from Acrisure Stadium after the break. Welcome back. We'll begin the second quarter with the Giants in possession. They're looking at third and very long. Looking from the gun. Here's Jones. That one falls to the turf. Couldn't hang on. It's incomplete. He can't hang on to the pass. And they're going to be stuck with a fourth and long.
Hey, listen, drops happen in football, even from the best at every level. Nothing more to do but shake it off and move forward, because the next throw might be right back your way.
Hunter takes the field on fourth down, and he sends this one flying. And before that return amounts to much, they bring him down. The kicking team got downfield quickly there. He didn't manage much on the return. And it's going to be their football coming up. The Steelers with some very good field position as they get set first and 10. Shotgun snap for Wilson. He finds Austin complete. And he made a bid for midfield there, but stopped at his own side at the 49. Give him 11 yards, Brock, and a fresh set of downs.
It sure seemed like he knew exactly where he was going with that right off the snap.
First and 10 from a yard shy of midfield. So he jumped too early, and that's going to cost him 5 yards. Encroachment on that previous play, and that makes this a much shorter first and 5. Russ is going to cook here. It's taken in by Washington. They come through with a nice gain there. Gain of 10, first down.
Nice to see that connection, that chemistry working between the two of them.
First down, ball at the 36. From the gun, it's Wilson. That throw finds Pickens. He gets forward, that's about 4 yards. Brian Burns coming up with the stop. Second and 6 coming up here. Wilson to throw again. Throwing deep towards the end zone. And he's there to send that one away, incomplete. Looking for George Pickens that time. And that means third down coming up.
You know, a couple of my favorite nicknames, Kate, over the last decade in football, the Legion of Boom, obviously out in Seattle. But how about the no-fly zone that was cooking in Denver? That right there, that is a no-fly zone. Trying to make the play in the end zone, and a beautiful job by the defender to knock it away.
Cover man is there, and he harmlessly knocks it away. Incomplete.
I know a DB in the stat sheet loves to see INT and not PBU, but as soon as he realized a pick wasn't possible, he does the next best thing and knocks it away.
Facing fourth down, the Steelers opting for the field goal. Chris Boswell out to do the honors. He was money on his first field goal, Brock. His second coming a little inside of 50 yards.
Inspiring a bunch of confidence in himself right there, Kate. Second time they brought him out for a field goal, and second time that he's knocked it right through. Trust is earned in a number of different ways on the field. That's the best way to gain it as a kicker.
Boswell on to send this away. His return starts at the 5. He's got a lead up past the 30. He showed some burst on that return, getting them all the way to their own 40. Here come the Giants, ready to take over again on offense. They were only on the field for 3 plays their prior series, Brock. Let's see what changes they make to take over here. Good starting field position for the Giants as they head up first and 10. Here's Jones to throw. Finds his target, Robinson. And he'll get it up to the 44. Second and 6 coming up here. Here's Jones. Gets this to Johnson. And he's down. Looks like they made the stop at the 46-yard line. Give him 9 on that play, and it's enough for the first.
Well, they got him down before he could do any more damage in terms of yards. That's no easy job, mind you, tackling a big tight end. But the main damage had already been done. He kept this drive going by getting beyond the line of gain.
First down throw by Jones. Catch is made. It's Jalen Hyatt. And out of bounds right at the 40-yard line.
Kate, if there was one throw in the game plan that kept me up at night more than any other, it was an out route versus zone coverage. Because you got to throw with anticipation, and you also got to make sure those defenders' eyes aren't reading you like a book.
Second down run by Singletary. And he's still looking for the play that sparks the ground game as that one stopped for a loss.
What was supposed to move the chains, or at least make third down easier to handle instead? But the exact opposite here, Kate. Now makes this third down a whole lot trickier to figure out.
Let's see what they draw up on this 37. Now Jones. He's holding up. They're able to drop it. And the defense comes through to back him up and hit a fourth down.
You know those elite zone defenses in basketball, Kate. It just feels like they're everywhere, clogging up every passing lane. This quarterback, well, he felt the same thing when he dropped back, nowhere to go but for a sack.
Jamie Gillen on out of punt. And he's going to try to give his defense a long field to defend. And this will fly out of bounds to deny a return. They're going to mark it a little before the 20. Pittsburgh getting its offense all set to go. And they brought out their kicker for a field goal, their last possession. This time they'll look to bring him out for an extra point instead. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. Wilson now from the gun. Fryer meet there and bring it in. He'll go down after pushing this up to the 29. After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. A handoff for Harris, running right. Up the sideline, past the 40. He'll move the sticks after ripping off a gain of 28.
That's the type of run that shines the light well, and him as a runner, of course, we've got to give a lot of credit to everybody else. The skill guys, when you have an outside run, they got to do their job. Not just the big boys up front, not just the running backs. That takes everyone on the perimeter blocking to get a big run like that.
Let's see how they attack this first down, Brock, from the 43. Staying on the ground with Harris. The stop. I'm going to say it about the 37-yard line. We made him 6 on the play, bringing up second and 4.
A humble 5 to 6 yard gain on the ground. Not a huge gain, not a game-changing play by any means, but one that keeps you on schedule and takes some of the starch out of that front seven.
After a good pickup, they've got 2nd and 4. From the 37. Caught by Freiermuth. And they haul him down just a foot or two shy of the red zone. He finds him 16 yards and a new set of downs.
I think my favorite part was the magic he worked after the catch. The way he took the completion and made so much more out of it by adding all the extra yardage.
Still on the move, coming to the line for 1st and 10. This is Harris. And he'll push this upfield and earn them a new set of downs.
Kate, don't think for a second this is time you step off the gas. You can feel this defense, right? They're on their heels. And now's the best chance to go push the envelope and get aggressive.
They're now set for 1st and 10. Harris once more. And they bring him down pretty quickly at the 10. Manages just a yard on 1st down. Now it's going to be 2nd and 9.
The only thing I can say positive about the execution of that play is at least he didn't go backwards.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Here's Wilson. The throw is caught. And he drives this forward to the 6.
This defense didn't give up contain there, Kate. That was an instance where the more exciting plays were taken away downfield. And even looking to the tight end wasn't going to net them much.
So now here's 3rd and 5. Wilson to throw it. And he's going to score. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. The Steelers go up by 12. Slant route, as it does so many times every game we call, Brock. Paying dividends. Made that touchdown look a lot easier than it was.
An uncontested release that close to the end zone spells disaster for a defense every time, Kate. You got to have a whole lot more physicality at the point of attack because a QB is always going to be looking for that short little slant near the goal line.
Boswell gets that point after the go. And the Steelers bump the lead up to 13 points. Boswell on to send this away. Fielded at the 7. He's got a lane up past the 30. The tackle's made, so this drive will begin at the 34-yard line. Now here comes the New York offense. And I'm sure they're tired of bringing out the punter, Brock. They're hopefully going to give him some rest this time around and find some points to go after that lead. Here's 1st and 10 from the 34. Pistol now for Jones. It's going to be an incomplete pass on the throw to the right.
You know, in the NFL, offensive-minded teams would call it a perfect fire. They don't want the ball to hit the ground once. And especially on these short to intermediate throws, they'll count on those being efficient and effective.
So after the incompletion, here comes the 2nd down call. Gets this to Slayton.
Okay, over the years, I've heard defensive coordinators say, hey, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. You got to earn the right for me to call blitzes. And when you call a blitz and you don't get home and you don't hit the quarterback, you've earned nothing.
So a tough spot now. This is 3rd and 9. And the shotgun, it's Jones. And he just gets rid of this one, but unfortunately, that means fourth down coming up.
Well, that's one you chalk up to the pressure earning that incompletion. They came in before he could find the target, hit him, altered that last-second attempt to get rid of it.
The Giants are set to punt. And this is going to be his fourth effort tonight. And he gets his guys a few yards before they bring him down on the return. The Steelers and Najee Harris making their return to the field. They've got first down from the 31. Carried by Harris here to stop the drive. And he's going to be brought down at the 42. That's an 11-yard pickup, and it gives them the first down.
Some backs are easier to tackle than others. Some, well, they just choose violence. They look for those opportunities to bust through tackles and keep those legs pumping.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. They put a receiver in motion right. They'll run here on first down. He's found some space as he crosses the 45. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with first and goal.
Now, you got a game changer as a wide receiver. You want to get the ball in his hands any way you can. And I love that call. Right, we see it all the time on bubbles and quick little receptions. But put the ball in his hands as a runner, and this dude's dynamic.
Four downs now to get in. Here's first and goal. From the red zone now. He's got it! And this one's stopped at the 3-yard line.
Well, he saw his guys pick up the blitz. Well, he felt them pick it up anyway if he wasn't looking at him. But with their effort on his behalf, I think this QB felt owed to them and the group up front to find somebody to get a completion so that effort up front wasn't in vain.
It's the 2-minute warning now from Acrisure. The Steelers with a chance to add to their lead. Ball still at the 3 as they get set for second and goal. Russ now from the gun. Pocket isn't holding up. They're able to drop it. And they're headed in reverse after that sack.
Bend. Even good defenses, great defenses in this league, Kate, they're going to bend at times, but you never want to break. And when you get a sack in the red zone, well, that goes a long ways to helping your efforts.
They've held him out twice. Here we go. Third and goal. Throwing is Wilson. Forced out to his right. And he carries it in for the touchdown. Russell Wilson with the touchdown. His third total score in this game. At this distance, a very dangerous player on any pass play because, Brock, as he's scanning the field to throw for the end zone, he's looking for an avenue to run it to.
Kate, this is exactly why it's never been harder to play defense in the NFL. The precision and the execution in the passing game, the efficiency has never been better. But then when you do cover it up, you got guys like this who can scramble and make you pay with their legs.
One after up and good from Boswell. And the Steelers push the lead to 20. Now Boswell on to send this away. Return coming from the 6. He stopped on the return at the 27. The Giants about to get to work on offense. They're trailing, but there's enough time, Brock, that they could get a scoring drive to attack that here before the break. and set. First and 10. Jones. Quick slant caught by Neighbors. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. Only one play in, Brock, and this drive already to midfield. On first down, it's Jones to throw. Down, looks like at the 32-yard line. A 19-yard pickup, and that's going to move the chains.
You know what I love about this? Never showing panic. When he leaves the pocket, look at his eyes. They continue to search downfield. They're never looking at the rush. They're finding the open man downfield before running out of real estate.
Escapes the pocket. And he protects himself for the slide there after a decent gain. Timeout calls, and that's going to be the second for New York. And they still have one in their pocket for what's left of this half. Second and 3 now. Working from the gun. Here's Jones.
Pretty clear, isn't it? It's this constant pressure that this defense has imposed on this offense to keep them out of rhythm and build up this lead. This offense is not going to offer a comeback if this quarterback continues to run for his life.
Just before halftime, we get a timeout taken. Only time left for one more snap, Brock, so they're going to run out their field goal unit. This from 48 on the left hash. And that one is good. A little longer, but no problem at all. And the deficit goes from 20 to 17.
It depends on the kicker, man. That is a coach's best friend. Saves him so much stress to have a guy he can really trust to go out and hit it from that distance consistently. Because from that far out, no kick is a guarantee.
Touchback. This kickoff should run out the half, so better make that return good as it's away. And he opts not to bring this one out, so they're going to enjoy some good starting field position from the 30. One last play before the break. Turn to the ground game and just run this clock out. And the defense gets there to force a small loss. So we arrive at halftime here in Pittsburgh. The Steelers leading after 2. Now we'll send you south to Orlando for a check-in around the league via Jonathan Coachman and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, what you got for us?
All right, Kate, sit tight. We'll get back to you and Brock in just a moment. But for now, this is our Halftime Report. The Steelers got a solid performance in that first half from their veteran QB, Russell Wilson. He accounted for 3 touchdowns in that first half. 1 in the air, 2 more on the ground. And he's been electrifying to this point.
The Giants ready to kick this one away, and off we go once more. Patterson now to return it. He stopped on the return at the 27. Now the offense getting set to go for the Steelers. And whether it was their game plan or not, they were pretty quick to realize the ground game, yeah, that was working. And they made that the centerpiece of what they were doing offensively.
Yeah, the great thing when you get a run game like this going in the first half is you know it will lay the foundation for what's to come. These guys will be energized going into that locker room at halftime, and they'll be excited to build on that foundation in the second half.
Offense ready to begin this drive. First and 10. He'll start with a give to Harris. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. It's a 30-yard play, Brock, and they've got a fresh set of downs.
No threats, nothing fancy. That was just a good old offensive line dominated in the trenches. And that sprung him to get to the second level and beyond.
So the big play gets him inside the opposing 45. Brock with a new set of downs to boot. First down, here's Russ. Has him on the quick hitter. And they're on him after about a 2-yard gain. Cordell Flott there on the stop. Eight yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. From the gun, it's Wilson. On the move, hit it right. Oh, he was on the move, but so was the defense, and they take him down. And that pushes him back, third down coming up.
This is one of those situations where QB's strength and ability to run can be a great blessing, but can also be a curse. We've seen him use his feet before. This guy can escape, and that's a blessing. But it can be a curse because sometimes you think you can get out of everything. And this defense just proved he couldn't.
Gotta figure out this third down here. Shotgun snap for Wilson. Touchdown. I love plays like this, Brock. Sometimes you just gotta ask your dude, show me what you got, man. Show off those wheels, and he did just that.
Yeah, beauty in simplicity, right?
Yeah.
Now, when you run that fly route, you gotta win right from the jump.
Uh-huh.
And you gotta protect yourself from the sideline, too. Don't get pushed to the boundary. Give your quarterback room to throw it up, and you can find Pater.
Boswell gets that point after to go. And the Steelers make it a 24-point ball game. Now Boswell on to send this away. Starting from the 5. He's brought down at what looks like the 24-yard line. The Giants offense all set to get started. And this game might be going better if he could have some more time just to work back there. This pass rush has been all over them. Really keeps taking this offense out of any grooves that they've managed to get into.
Okay, I like to say in life, there's energy givers and there's energy vampires.
Yeah.
And for this defense, these sacks right here, they're such energy givers. And man, it's like a vampire sucking the juice out of an offense.
Yeah, I love that. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. They give up the gut to Singletary. He's got a gain of 6 there. Minka Fitzpatrick in on the stop. A nice 6-yard pickup. They're going to have 2nd and 4.
That does not show up on any explosive stat sheet, but let me tell you, Kate, that's the real deal right there. You run for that kind of yardage consistently in the NFL, you do set yourself up for success.
Second and four. Neighbors with the catch. And this one's brought to a halt at about the 36-yard line. 6 yards on the play and enough for a first. To Singletary from the gun. And he wants. It's a loss on the play.
Well, you often see some mix, some high percentage pass plays on first and 10. You got to keep the defense honest. They're always looking for a run in that situation and a chance to stack them up for second and long.
Everyone's prepped. It's second down now. From the gun, it's Jones. Buys time, rolling right. He's on the move.
This is one of those occasions that it looks so promising when you take off as a quarterback, and then you're reminded just how fast these defenses are in the NFL. Couldn't quite move the chains, but it wasn't for a lack of trying.
All plays on the table here for third and three.
It's easy for me to say up here in the friendly confines of the booth kick, but that was not the right read. And you hate seeing him absorb yet another hit at the end of the play. You never want him taking unnecessary shots throughout this game.
They'll bring out the punter here. And this will mark his fifth kick of the night. He sends this away. Definitely his best kick of the game thus far. Brings it in at the 12. He gets him out of the deep part of their half. This is out across the 20. That punt finishes as a 60-yard effort. And they'll get ready to go on offense. And the drive will start out with a first and 10. Now an inside handoff to Harris. And he's brought down after a nice gain and a first down. Takes this one. And he gets him around six there. Brian Burns coming up with the stop. Give him around six. That's going to make it second and four.
You gain that kind of yardage in the run game, and you're going to gain the trust of your offensive coordinator. Plays like that, runs like that, set the table for everything else in the playbook.
This is Harris on second down. And they'll take him down at the 43-yard line. It's a gain of four. And that's a Steelers first down.
Ooh, I like that. I really like that execution to move the chains. Now that third down call that they had ready, well, they could stick it right back in their pocket for a later occasion.
Let's see how they attack this first down, Brock, from the 43. Now Wilson on the play fake. He's throwing deep to the left side. That's incomplete for the moment. We do have a flag down, but it might not be good news for their offense. That's usually where we see holding calls. You got a major fistful of jersey on that play, and it's going to end up costing them. Shotgun snap. They're going to throw. And he just gets rid of it. Knew he had a couple of plays left. Didn't want to take a risk there on first down. No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Russ is going to cook here. And that's nearly intercepted, but couldn't hang on. Just a harmless incompletion. It's third down.
Hey, Kate, you feeling lucky? Well, the quarterback is, because he just dodged a major turnover. That was an easy pick that was simply dropped.
Last pass unsuccessful, and they have third down here. Wilson. He's going to loft one deep to the left. Big game downfield. They rip off a big check of field, and it sets him up with first and goal.
Speaks for this guy's talent. He's just an all-around difference maker, playmaker. We see him line up as a receiver, and we don't even bat an eye, Kate. And we don't really bat an eye when he makes that kind of play either. This guy's just different, built for the moment.
This offense in position now. It's first and goal. Before the snap, some early movements. Let's see which side gets tagged with the penalty. He thought he had the timing down and could make the play, but just a hair too early. They'll break the huddle and come up on first and goal. Throwing again. Here's Wilson. He's on the move. And he's brought down real close to that goal line at the one.
It's one of those situations, not much to be had there, no matter what he did with the ball. Even if he scraped a positive gain out of it, that's still a win and a confidence builder for this defense.
Now it's second and goal from the one. Harris goes up and over for the touchdown. The Steelers piling onto the scoreboard yet again. Najee Harris, the touchdown. Ooh, baby, Brock, this one has gotten well out of hand.
You think so? I think this is utter domination. Going to be a lot of questions to be answered. I'm going to guess this is a press conference the coach isn't looking forward to.
One after up and good from Boswell. And the Steelers continue piling on to this lead. Now Boswell on to send this away. Here's a return from the 7. And this drive will start inside the 25. Now outruns their offense to take over. Now their last drive, not the one they want to replicate after they were forced to punt it away. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. Shotgun snap, looking to throw. That's incomplete for the moment. We do have a flag down, but it might not be good news for their offense. That's usually where we see holding calls. So the refs get him for holding, and that's going to back this offense up. Holding penalty is going to make first down twice as tough. They're 20 from the marker to start things out. They go play fake with Jones. He lobs it up, looking deep to the right side. A disaster averted. He knocks away the deep ball, incomplete.
The ability to track the ball. Right, ball skills isn't just knocking it away, and that's a beautiful job there, Kate. But ball skills is also being able to track the ball on a deeper throw like that. If he doesn't swat it away, we're looking at a huge game.
They'll run with Singletary. He's forward, gets a couple of yards. Tackled by the venerable Cameron Hayward. Only a couple there, hoping obviously for considerably more. And that's going to bring up third and very long. Blitz coming for Jones. Setting up the running back screen. And the defense is all over this one for a big loss.
Not terribly complicated on this one, just not the third down screen you wanted to run. Little chance they were getting the first, and apparently, little chance they were going to even gain a positive yard at all.
Punt team on the field. And after that drive went backwards, he's going to send this one forward. And the fair catch is made just about a yard or two short of midfield. The Steelers down Russell Wilson, headed back to the field now. The Steelers with some very good field position as they get set first and 10. Wilson to throw it. His ball's cut by Pickens. And he has it to the 42 before they make the stop.
Kate, one thing I learned from the late, great Mike Leach is, yeah, the system was called air raid, but it wasn't just attacking downfield. His philosophy, and it played out right there, is you have to attack every inch of the field, both vertically and horizontally, without routes or in routes, just like that.
And the receiver's gonna take this one on the jet sweep. And he's stopped. Now we'll wait to hear what this flag is all about. But partner, they say there's holding on every play. You just gotta look for it, right? That time, though, we did not have to look too hard. Second and 12 behind the sticks. Freiermuth there to bring it in. And he's brought down after pushing to that 35-yard line. They'll get 18 yards there. And it'll bring up a Pittsburgh first down.
And those are the completions they rely on from their passing game.
They're set up at the 35 now. First and 10, give to Harris. And he'll pull his way ahead for a 4-yard pickup.
You know, this is an offense that will emphasize the ground game at different points of each and every contest. And as long as they can reliably get gains like this, it's not going to change anytime soon.
Second and 6 coming up here. Going right side, Harris with it. And he's brought down for a loss.
You know, that's so hard for me, Kate. That's the type of effort that deserves better when it comes to the results. It's going to show up as a negative run on the stat sheet, but that was not the runner's fault. He did all he could to fight to get back to the line, but this defense just kept swarming.
It looks like the defense jumps just before the snap there. Broke the plane before the snap, and that's going to give the offense some free yardage. Runner pass, which way they want to go to convert on third. Wilson now from the gun. Complete beyond the marker. And he's tackled with the first down yardage.
That pitch and catch won't show up as a big play on the stat sheet, but it gives his own defense a little time to rest and gives an offensive coordinator a new set of downs to work with.
All right, set now, first and 10. Working inside the red zone. That throw finds Pickens. And they get this down to the 7-yard line. The a gain of 13, and it sets him up with first and goal. Only one quarter remains in our final game of the week. That's the end of the third. It's the Steelers with it to begin the fourth, and this game entering blowout territory. Four downs now to get in. Here's first and goal. Trying to run in, Harris. And they'll make this stop after a small push to the five. Give him a couple on the run, and it's now second and goal. Ross off the play fake. Brock, it wasn't hard to see why they botched on that play fake. Even our camera operator was fooled into thinking it was a run, but certainly made it easier to connect on that touchdown pass.
And that's all about the attention to details, Kate. Really is. The offensive line getting their pads down, the running back and quarterback at that mesh point, making it look exactly like a run. You do the details on the front end, and the play action game rewards follow on the back end.
Boswell to add the PAT. Right down the middle, it's good. And the Steelers grow their lead yet again. Now Boswell on to send this away. Fielded at the seven. And in the end, he's able to get it to what used to be a touchback. It's at the 25 after the return. Back out runs their offense. And all game, they have struggled to attack this deficit. Maybe they can do a little window dressing here. They're out and set, first and 10. Putting a receiver in motion. First down, throw by Jones. He had it for a moment, but a great defensive play to jar it loose, incomplete.
See the pass, time up your hit, and jar that ball loose. Not a lot of players are hanging on to a well-placed hit like that one.
Couldn't connect on first, it's second down. Here's Jones. Finds his target, Robinson. And this one gets to the 33-yard line before it stopped.
Kid, I was on the field with a young high school quarterback just last week, and I told him one of the greatest attributes a quarterback can have is courage. And it takes courage to sit in that pocket that long, let a play develop, and let that receiver work all the way from one side of the field to the other. Give him a chance to make a play.
It will hit Robinson, complete. And he'll get it up near the 38-yard line before going down. 5 yards on that play and enough for a new set of downs. They have themselves another first and 10. Again, Jones to the air. Able to get it to Singletary. And he's out of bounds just past, looks like, the 40-yard line.
As an offense, you don't call a screen, Kate, expecting to gain just a few yards. You call it expecting to break out something big and substantial. But it's up to that defense to stay ahead of it to keep it contained to something much smaller. Case in point right there.
Second and six coming up here. Receiver in motion, headed right. Play fake, Jones. Bails it. And they get Jones, he was trying to make something happen. And that pushes him back, third down coming up.
Final quarter, this quarterback's just feeling the need to do a little extra, try to make something happen outside the pocket. The problem, defense wouldn't let him. They have that same kind of urgency. They want to make some plays of their own before they hit the showers. And they got one right there with that sack.
Drive in dire straits. It's third and nine. Jones now to throw. That's into the hands of Singletary. And this one does not go far.
Awareness. Kate, you hear me and so many others talk about it a lot with quarterbacks, but it's critical for every unit on the football field. And for the defense right there, having awareness of knowing where the marker was and to make sure that completion wasn't going to move the chains.
Desperation time here on fourth. This is complete to Neighbors. And he'll be brought down a step or two shy of midfield. They're going to mark him at the 48. And they drag him down just in time. He's shy of that marker. We've got a turnover on downs.
You go for it on fourth down, it's got to be something from the short list of plays you expect to work every time. If that one's on the short list, I think it's got to be reevaluated. Something wasn't working on it, and it cost them a possession.
First and 10, ball set up at the 48. A give left side, here's Harris. And they make the stop, we're gonna say it about the 37-yard line. Pickup of 12 on that play. And that's a Steelers first down.
Ooh, I like that call. I really like it with those sticks you can keep on the sidelines and you get more than enough to get the first down.
Markers reset, ball at the 37. First down, and they go right back to it. And he gets this one down to the 30-yard line. Good run, gets him seven. That brings up second and three.
That's what I call a rhythm starter right there. Man, offenses love execution and plays like that on first down, Kate, because now that playbook is wide open. All options on the table for second down.
Second and three now. Give to Harris from the gun. And they bring him down after the play reaches the 26. A pickup of two, maybe three, but most importantly, Brock, that's enough to move the sticks.
You know what I like about a second and short run play, Kate? Yeah, I like getting a first down, but you know what I like even more? That's going to set up a play action pass in a similar down and distance, and that defense is going to have to key on the run.
Going to the ground again on first. Has some space inside the 15. Is in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. The Steelers running them out of the building. Najee Harris, the touchdown. It's what every player who scores a touchdown wants to do, Brock. He wants to get right back there and put another six on the board.
I've never met an NFL player content with one end zone trip in a game.
Nope.
Yeah, if you're content, you're not making it to this league. You get one, you're instantly thinking of another, and the fortunate few are able to actually deliver on it.
Boswell to add the PAT. The point after splits the uprights. And the Steelers tack on seven more to their lead. Now Boswell on to send this away. His return starts at the five. His return makes it up to the 25. Their offense ready to take the field now. Offense ready to begin this drive, first and 10. On the shotgun, it's Jones. Chased out to his right. He takes it himself. It's out of harm's way after stringing together some nice yards on that run.
You know, Kate, back in the day, we had a slip and slide to practice for moments just like that. Actually practicing how to slide and get out of harm's way. Nice gain on the play, and denied that defense yet another chance to take a shot on him.
Second and 3 now. They kick the running back in motion. Second and 3. Has him on the quick hitter. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains. Markers reset, ball at the 37. Jones on first down. Escapes the pocket. He's keeping it. And he's tackled for no gain.
Well, I think all quarterbacks have been there before. You start scrambling, you're hoping for something to materialize, and nothing does. You just try to get back to the line, live to play another day, and more importantly, avoid a loss.
Second and 10, need to get some positive yardage here. Looking from the gun, here's Jones. Connects with Slayton. And he'll get it up to the 44. All plays on the table here for 3rd and 3. Singletary, and the defense gets there to force a small loss.
It'd be kind of fun, Kate, to be able to measure these coordinators' blood pressure, temperature, because a 3rd down screen for negative yards, I promise you that coordinator's heated on the sidelines.
Their punter making his way out now. It's going to be Jamie Gillen doing the honors. Fair catch hauled in at the 18-yard line. The Steelers are being led back out there on offense by their quarterback. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. More than one defender, their powerful runner stopped for just 1 yard.
Well, now this defense is in the driver's seat, Kate, right? When you make a stop like that on 1st down, now it's your discretion of just how aggressive you want to be following that play up.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Staying on the ground with Harris. And he's got a decent gain before being brought down. They get about 4 there, need a little more than that now on 3rd and 6.
When you don't have great success on 1st down, Kate, it's a little bit like a hitter in baseball falling behind in the count. And all you want to do as a hitter is get back to a fighting chance. Give yourself a better count. That play, well, does the same here. Now a much more manageable and opportune 3rd down situation.
And he'll get it up to the 27. It's a 4-yard run. Wow, it leaves him just a yard short on 4th down. The Steelers set to punt it. And this is the 2nd time he's been brought on to kick it. His first effort went 47 yards. Bronk looks to have a little more into this one. And he's getting nothing on that return. They wrap him up almost at the exact spot that he fielded that punt. It's a 54-yard punt that time. And it'll be Giants football. Here's first and 10 from the 34. Operating from the gun, it's Jones. He throws a bullet down the left sideline. And he has it along the sideline, but he got a little too close to that edge. They're going to say he's out of bounds. We've got second down.
You know, Kate, that's one of those instances where you try to walk that tightrope on the sidelines. Problem is, on a throw that far down the field, that is so hard to do, so difficult. I love the effort, just couldn't quite find the execution.
Second and 10 now. Jones gets this to Johnson. And it's a nice game, but still not enough for the first.
The smartest pass catchers I've ever been around, they know how to set up an outcut beautifully. They recognize when they have leverage, how to sell the deep route, and then boom, they just break it out as if it's nothing.
That brings us to the two-minute warning in Pittsburgh. Giants just want to get out of here with how this one is gone. Here we go, third and less than a yard. To throw, here's Jones. That's caught for the first. And he'll be taken down, but not until he reaches that 45-yard line. It's a gain of 12 there. And it's good enough for a New York first down.
Gosh, I really like this receiver on that drag route in particular. Why? Because he's a guy that creates after the catch. They don't close quickly, he can take it to the house.
And he has it along the sideline, but he got a little too close to that edge. They're going to say he's out of bounds. We've got second down.
Boy, offenses that connect in this intermediate zone are so effective. Getting the completion in that area, it not just sparks your offense, but it just turns that aggressive meter way up. And just couldn't quite find the connection.
To throw again here on second and 10. Jones connects with Johnson. And they get there to take him down right around the 41. Let's see what they draw up on a third and 7. Here's Jones to throw. Incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact.
Well, that was almost one of those nice chunk plays you like to see in the NFL, Kate, before he was able to recover and provide the hit and ultimately dislodge the football. You like to see that physical edge and scrappiness to contest any kind of shot plays down the field.
Punt team is on now, and they get this away. And that is how you pin a team deep. That hits and careens out of bounds at the 3. The home teams returning their offense and this running back to the field. And the drive will start out with a 1st and 10. Carried by Harris here to start the drive. And he powers through the middle for a gain of 4.
He'll expect more from himself on those type of plays, but there is nobody that's going to complain about that one. If you can do math, 4 + 4 + 4 equals a first down.
2nd and 6 coming up here. And they don't get the snap away in time. This is going to move them half the distance. Must have lost sight of the play clock there, Brock, because the quarterback could have snapped it in time, but instead, they take the penalty. Back to the line they go. It's 2nd down. They'll run here following the penalty. And he's tackled with a 1st down yardage. shutout, Brock. But keeping that other side off the board in the second half, that sure went a long way towards securing them this win. Made things a lot easier for everyone else to operate in the closing stages of the game. So that's it for us here. Brock Heward, our crew, I'm Kate Scott. This has been the NFL on EA Sports. The Steelers are winners as we say so long from Pittsburgh.